We're exactly a month away from Indiana's May primary. There's a crowded field of candidates running for Indiana's 9th congressional seat. Sitting Congressman Trey Hollingsworth has already announced he's not running for re-election. Our Dan Spieler has been speaking with several of the 9 Republicans hoping to replace him.
What's your message to voters in the 9th, which has at times been something of a swing district? It's certainly been more red here in recent years. What's your message to voters in the 9th who might be in more of those purple areas of the 9th district in terms of electing someone to represent the entire district?
You know, what I would say is one of the things that people have said about me during my time in the Senate is I do what I say I'm going to do. I don't go out there or go to Indy and do one thing and then come back and tell constituents another. So what you see is what you get. I have been known as a conservative fighter, but I want what's best for Hoosiers, and I want what's best for the state of Indiana. I'll always fight for my district, and that's the type of member of Congress I'll be. But I, you know, the district itself is fairly conservative, and they talk about what they want to see is get inflation under control so they have more to spend, so the cost of groceries to gas doesn't cost them, you know, and hurt their family budgets. They want border security. They want energy independence. They really want, in the district, they do want an America First agenda, and that's what I'll be bringing to Congress.
What are you making the conversation in your party now about former President Trump? Obviously, the events of January 6th weighing heavily on the minds of a lot of people in Congress. You served in Congress. You saw the events of that day. Some Republicans think it's time to maybe move on, find a different candidate for 2024. Others still feel Donald Trump is the face of the Republican Party. What did you make of the events of that day, his handling of it, and his position within the party now?
Well, you know, everybody wants to revisit the past, if you will, and I told somebody the other day, even God doesn't change the past. It is what it is. You know, I don't know if President Trump will run again. I know the country was better off economically under President Trump, and we can't have a strong defense unless we have a strong economy. The strong economy is the key to everything. It's the key to trying to balance the budget. It's the key to the strong defense. Unless you have that firm foundation under you, you can't get anything done from a governmental standpoint.
You'd support him if he is the party's nominee in 2024?
If he was the nominee, I certainly would.
Do you think the GOP moving forward to 2024 should look to somebody like Donald Trump, former President Trump, as a candidate to run again or move toward a new generation of candidates?
I think the Republican Party needs to be accepting of multiple points of view. We need to bring more people into our party. We're seeing that now because of the failed policies of Joe Biden's administration. I do think we need to get back to what the founders envisioned for our country, which is that people leave their everyday lives, whatever career they have, a teacher, farmer, businessman, whatever it is they're doing with their lives, they leave, they go to Congress, they give something, they have something to offer, and then they go back to their daily lives. I think that's an important system that the founders created, and we need to get back to that. I think that we have far too many career politicians who spend their lives in Washington, D.C., who don't understand what it's like to get a job in this economy, to raise a family in this country, to get health care in this country, to get a retirement system in this country. And so our politicians need to learn to live under the laws that they create. And so I believe in term limits.
And it seems to be happening more and more. People like yourself from different backgrounds who have not served in politics before running for Congress. Why is that? Why are we seeing more of that now?
Well, look, I think there's a number of skill sets we need to bring to the table to solve the complicated problems that we're seeing in our country. And I think that a military background brings a certain skill set. I think that a business background brings a certain skill set. And I think that is why we're seeing success of people entering politics with some other tools to bring to the table and fight for Hoosiers and get things done.
I'm a deal maker. I've been a deal maker for over 40 years, bringing opposing parties together. Yes, we need to bring opposing parties together, but at the same time, we don't need to give up the principles that have made this country great.
What about this race for Congress? 9 candidates in this race, in this primary.
Right.
2 of them former or current state lawmakers. 1 of them held this seat in Congress prior. What do you need to do between now and the primary in May to try to get your name out there, raise enough money to win a race like this against candidates with more experience in public office?
candidates with more experience in public office are at a disadvantage. I'm at an advantage because I'm not a politician.